Hey everyone, I'm Norby Babos, the CTO at SolarKit, and I almost just said, don't forget to subscribe. Hey everyone, I'm Norby Babos, the CTO at SolarKit, and in this video, we'll talk about the MAP0 inverter. We'll go over advanced settings to show you how to configure features beyond basic installation, helping optimize performance, improving efficiency, and customize the system to fit your needs. If you'd like to get updates on our other videos and subscribe to the channel, you can do that below. Click the little bell icon to receive notifications and stay informed about new tutorials, product insights, and helpful solar energy tips. One of the most common concerns is the export limit. How to prevent feeding energy back into the grid efficiently. If you go into the app and select the power adjustment function, you'll find an option called limited feed-in. Under control mode, set it to grid connected with zero power. This means that we are connected to the grid, but we do not feed energy back into the grid, but only generates the exact amount of power that your property consumes, maximizing self-use and efficiency. When selecting limitation mode, new options will appear. Here, choose the setting that monitors each phase individually, ensuring your inverter adjusts production accordingly and prevents any excess energy from flowing back into the grid. If it is set up, it will now look at the phases separately and will not release energy back to the grid on any of the phases. So it is about MAP0 inverter that is already asymmetric inverter for you, and you can switch the asymmetry on and off. This could be important because it's still a question how it comes out of the packaging, whether it's switched on at the factory or not. So we'll show you where you can switch it on. You have to use the power adjustment menu to do that. Here you'll find the split phase power control option. To enable asymmetry, simply toggle the three phase imbalance control setting to enable for proper functionality. And you will have a symmetrical inverter. The level of asymmetry the inverter supports depends on the rated power of the inverter. For this 8 kilolev inverter, the way it works is that while connected to the grid, we can still efficiently utilize power from the public network as needed. In this setup, the inverter can output a maximum of 1/3 of its rated power to a single phase. For this 8 kilolev inverter, that means roughly 2.6 kilolevs is the maximum power it can reliably and efficiently supply to a single phase at any time. If a single phase has a 3 kilowatt load, the inverter supplies up to 2.6 kilowatts directly. Due to its per phase limit, the remaining 400 watt is drawn from the grid, ensuring system stability, preventing overload, and maximizing self-consumption efficiency. If there is consumption on other phases or no consumption, then we can deviate from 2.6 downwards. So if, for example, if the total usage across three phases is 500 watt, 1 kilo or 2 kilo, then the inverter will only supply that amount, ensuring no excess energy is drawn from or fed back into the grid. This applies in on-grid mode. If you have an off-grid, so your grid goes down, you can deliver the same nominal power on three phases. The same numbers apply, so it's 33% for one phase. But we can overload it, and we can go up to 150% of that in one phase. So we can power up to about 4 kilowatts for 5 minutes until we're below 4 kilowatts. And we can use 200% of the total nominal energy, i.e. the energy per phase for 10 seconds, so double the 2.6 kilowatts, that's. For example, with a 2.6 kilowatt limit per phase, this means up to 5.2 kilowatt for 10 seconds. Why is this useful? If you have a single phase load, like a pump or motor, which requires a higher startup power, this feature ensures the inverter can handle it. Once the load stabilizes, its power consumption decreases to a more stable and moderate level. Ideally, this will be below 2.6 kilowatt, allowing the inverter to supply power consistently and efficiently. This is why the asymmetry feature and the 150-200% overload threshold are crucial for optimal performance and reliability, are so useful in real-world applications, ensuring flexibility, efficiency, and stability during varying energy demands. This covers the key points of asymmetry settings and their benefits, helping you optimize system performance. If your system includes Smart Guard, then Emma is the central device you'll connect to for comprehensive system monitoring and management. When logging into Emma, you'll notice a different menu layout compared to direct inverter access, as the inverter operates as a slave device under Emma's control, receiving commands and executing them accordingly. However, this doesn't mean the inverter is completely inaccessible. While logged into Emma, click the monitor icon in the middle left section. This will display all connected devices in your system, allowing you to access and review their status easily. You'll see an Emma, an inverter, and a backup box. The backup box functions as the Smart Guard, managing power transitions. Clicking on the inverter reveals its familiar menu, allowing you to monitor and adjust essential settings directly. From here, you can easily monitor all of the inverter's key parameters and performance. Configuration isn't usually necessary through this interface, since settings are managed through Emma. Any adjustments made in Emma are automatically communicated to the inverter, eliminating the need for manual configuration or additional setup steps. The same applies to battery management. Through Emma, you can easily configure the charge and discharge levels, determine how the battery is used, and set the appropriate operating mode. To adjust battery settings, log into Emma and navigate to the power adjustment menu, where you'll find a dedicated option called Battery Control for customization. Here you can set the battery's operating mode according to your energy needs. By default, maximum self-consumption is the recommended option, as it offers the most benefits and maximizes efficiency. However, you can also select time of use mode, where you define specific time periods for different actions, optimizing energy usage based on your consumption patterns. If you want to feed power back into the grid exclusively, you can configure those settings here as well, though in Hungary, this is generally less relevant. From this menu, you have full control over the battery's behavior. One more important aspect, if you are installing a MAP0 asymmetric inverter, the way energy is measured depends on how Emma is set up. Through Emma, you can configure whether it measures energy flow symmetrically, distributing power evenly or asymmetrically, monitoring each phase separately. This ensures accurate energy tracking based on your system and grid regulations. This is particularly relevant for users under gross metering, where consumption and feed-in are recorded separately for each phase to ensure accurate billing and compliance. Emma allows you to specify how energy flow is measured, giving greater control over system optimization, load balancing, and efficient energy distribution across all phases. For example, if energy flows in one direction on two phases while moving in the opposite direction on another, Emma can record each phase separately instead of summing them. This ensures each phase's energy consumption and feed-in are accurately accounted for, preventing misleading net zero readings. It is important to note that this setting does not enable or disable the inverter's asymmetry function. It strictly affects how energy measurements are processed and displayed, allowing for more precise monitoring and reporting. To adjust this setting, log into Emma, go to the Set tab, then select Set Installation Parameters. At the bottom, you'll find an important option called Energy Measurement Mode, which allows for precise customization of energy monitoring. By default, it's set to Balanced Measurement, but you can switch it to Unbalanced, which ensures each phase is measured separately. These readings will then be displayed individually in Fusion Solar. For example, if one phase exports energy while another imports it, the system won't cancel them out to zero. Instead, it will register the exported and consumed energy separately. These are key configuration options you'll likely encounter during installation. Adjusting these settings ensures your system operates efficiently and reliably, aligning with your energy needs. By fine-tuning these parameters, you can optimize performance, maximize self-consumption, and prevent energy losses, enhancing overall system efficiency. If you'd like to see the complete inverter setup process, you can find it at this link. If you'd like to see a quick introduction to the devices, their features, and benefits, you can find it here. And if you'd like to subscribe for updates and new content, you can do that right here. Bye.